So you have these kind of molecules, aptamers. Mm-hmm. Can you please elaborate on what they are and how do you measure actually the whatever you're measuring, for example, the neuropeptides?
Mm-hmm. This is my favorite part to explain because I think it's pretty cool. But you basically have these DNA sequences that, in our case, are designed to structure switch. So it really changes its morphology in 3D. So not all aptamers are structure switching. A lot of them have these lock and key type binding where you just have an aptamer, something clicks to it like antibodies. But in our case, they were designed in vitro to undergo a large conformational change. So DNA is very negatively charged because of its phosphodiester backbone. So if you have 40 bases in your DNA sequence, you have 40 negative charges. So now what we basically have is a DNA that has a certain structure, a molecule comes in, it changes its morphologies to really capture this analyte, which rearranges charge. So now as soon as you rearrange charge, you can start to transduce that at the surface of different materials, for example, semiconductors, at the surface of field effect transistors, where now you can have two electrodes, a source and drain electrode, you have a semiconducting channel, and you have, if it's an N-type semiconductor, you have electrons that carry the charge from the source to the drain electrode. So when the aptamer moves its backbone, it changes how much electrons can actually pass through the semiconductor by changing the charge density at the surface. And so we can really record that as a change in current. Is the current increasing? Is it decreasing? And we now really know that depending on how the aptamer structure switches, whether it compresses or it elongates or something in between, we get a very different signal transduction in terms of currents increasing versus decreasing, for example.